This video will cover the steps to utilize the spectrum analyzer and the advanced spectrum analyzer feature on the following Tsunami products. Tsunami Quickbridge 8000 series, the Tsunami MP 8000 series, the Tsunami Quickbridge 800 series, and the Tsunami MP 800 series. Couple of quick notes. The spectrum analyzer feature helps to analyze a spectrum for interference and to select a relatively low interference channel. This tool is limited in accuracy or capability and is not a direct substitution for professional deployment with a dedicated spectrum analyzer. Also, as the remote spectrum analyzer is being utilized, the WORP RF link will be briefly disconnected. The WORP RF link will reconnect after the spectrum analyzer scan has been completed.
First, we're going to cover when to use the spectrum analyzer. All right, for that, we're going to look at some of the statistics that are provided by the radio. CRC, PHY errors, and then some of the WORP statistics. So we're going to start along with the CRC and PHY errors. To get there, click on Monitor, Interface, and then Wireless 1. Scroll down, and you'll see your CRC and PHYs. Now, the CRCs indicate you have adjacent channel interference. PHY errors are co-channel interference. Right? So the easiest way to determine if you actually do have interference is when you do a refresh, and you want to do this about every 3 second interval, four times. What we're looking at is the CRCs. Now, you should never have a CRC error. Now, if it goes up higher than 5 to 6 every refresh rate, you have interference. That means your packets are corrupt. The CRCs are failed and TCP's kicking in. Okay. Now, the PHY errors, about 80 every refresh rate indicates that you have interference. Now, in my case, when you look at it, I hit refresh, everything is fine in my case. But if these numbers are going up, it's a clear indication that you have interference, and the spectrum analyzer is a good tool for that. So we're going to use channel 64 as an example at a 20 megahertz bandwidth. So as you could see here, kind of breaks it down by 11, 20, and 30 megahertz, and by power, 20 dB, 28, and 40. So as per the standard, at 11 megahertz from the center's frequency, which is channel 64 in that case, the power should be reduced by 20 dB. Okay. At 20 megahertz, which is out here, the power should be reduced by 28 dB, and from 30 megahertz, which is all the way out here, it's going to be reduced by 40 dB. So as you kind of see, the mask will actually take about 5 channels in either direction. So when you kind of look at it, and I'll show an example later, how to read the spectrum analyzer to indicate that you actually don't have interference, because you can kind of see it steps down. It will go down about 30 to 35 megahertz on either side, and that is normal. The transmit mask is limited by 40 dB or 45 dB for 11N radios at 30 megahertz from the center frequency, which is all the way out here. This rule applies to all 802.11 radios which use OFDM signal. Therefore, the actual spectrum will have sidebands of up to 30 megahertz, as mentioned before, going from here to here from either side of the second center frequency, which once again in our case is channel 64. And the power level of those sidebands depend on the power level of the center frequency. Now, there's a note. Tsunami radios can understand only 802.11 signal and treat all other signal as errors. The Tsunami spectrum analyzer scans each channel at 5 megahertz bandwidth and plots all 802.11 and non-802.11 signals, including errors. The results are plotted based on the power of the received signal and the activity count for that channel. So what does this all mean? So once again, we are using channel 64, and you could see how it kind of steps down once again, 30 megahertz on the other side. So if you see here, this is an actual scan for channel 64, and we're going to cover how to access the spectrum analyzer itself. But as you could see, this is the way it should look like. It should step down gradually as it does here. This indicates that there is no interference on channel 64 or any of the other channels, because it's actually just reading its own mask. Okay, so if you go this way, it should step down. Now, if this right here or this channel, any of these channels will be higher or at the same plane with the RSSI as the main channel, then you would have interference. That's going to be one of the easiest ways for you to determine. So if it kind of looks like this, like it's stepping down, you should be pretty good. If it's higher or up at the same power rating as the main channel, especially the ones that are about 25, 30 megahertz out, then you would have interference. So that's going to cause your CRCs, your adjacent channel, which is something we don't want. We covered a few items on the spectrum analyzer itself. Now it's time to actually use it. It is located under Monitor, Tools, and then Spectrum Analyzer. When you click on it, you're going to see this screen right here. So I'm going to go through some of these. So the channel scan time. This range is from 100 to 60,000 milliseconds. Okay? This is basically how long it's going to scan each channel. By default, the time is set to 1,000 milliseconds. Now remember, this is per channel, so if you're going to set it to 60,000 milliseconds, it's going to scan each channel for that long. So the longer the time is, the longer it's going to take to scan the channel. The scan reaction, this is a range from 1 to 1,000. This represents the number of times the scan will keep on going. Either you want to do it once, twice, three times, or whatever. By default, it's set to one time. Max, you could do it up to 1,000 times. Right, so we have the appropriate scan time, and then we also have the last time it was scanned. So after you made your changes, go ahead and click OK now for the actual scan itself. All you really do is just click Start. Now what's going to happen is this is going to drop the link, so you have to be very careful where you are. If you are located on the local side, but you're remoted into the remote base station, it's going to be satellite or subscriber unit endpoint B radio or vice versa, you are going to drop the link. Now it is going to come back eventually after the scan is done. So as right now, as you can see, it's kind of doing my scan. So I am on, let's see here, I am currently on channel 6160. So if I look at the spectrum analyzer, has it not reached that far because it's basically scanning all of the channels for right now. So right now I could tell you that I'm up in the lower bands. I got some interference and it's going to keep on going and going. So at the end, this is just going to show you what signals are being used. Going back to where we talked before, if you are on a specific channel, you are kind of looking for that step down. If pretty much every channel is occupied, you have interference. So there's just no doubt about it. Okay. Also kind of depending on the RSSI, the signal strength. So if you know what your signal strength is for a link, let's just say 45 dBm or negative 45 dBm, if it kind of creeps up there, you know that this signal is almost at your power range. So now best you could do is see if you could kind of change the channel. Once again, this is going to keep on going. If I click next, it's going to scoot over to the remainder of the channels. Because I'm in channel 160, it's just basically scanning all the channels. So it has not reached me quite yet. But once again, this is it. You're going to notice it, change the channel. Now, one thing you have to remember, and as we stated in the beginning, if you sense that you have interference and you're not quite sure, you have to use a real spectrum analyzer. This is just a quick look of what's out there. A real spectrum analyzer is going to help you out at each location, and you're going to have to go off by what that tells you. But once again, this is just giving you a quick look, a glimpse of what the radio sees, and you would have to do this on either end if it's a quick bridge or at each specific point if it's a MP radio, and then kind of pick the best channel from that. One thing I would like to add, the way that the base station and satellite radios work. The base stations transmit while the satellites receive. So basically what this indicates is that if you are on a base station and you do the scan, you will not see the satellite because really all it's doing is just sitting there and listening. Okay? Now, if you are on the satellite side, you will see the base station transmitting. So one thing that you could do, kind of food for thought, would be power down the base station if possible and then run the scan, because that's going to tell you if you have interference on that particular channel. Once again, on a subscriber, it will see the base. When you do it on the base, it's not going to see the subscriber. You know, so again, it's food for thought, but it will give you a better understanding, a bigger picture of what the satellite actually sees rather than a false signal, because it is going to be the base station that the satellite's going to see.
Now, the advanced spectrum analyzer feature works hand in hand with the basic feature. Let's go ahead and kind of start where it is. It's under monitor and then tools, spectrum analyzer, and click scan. It's going to bring up basic and then advanced. Now, we already covered basic, right? Just a quick one too. Let's just say that if we're using channel 39, what we're going to see is, because this is using a Wi-Fi type scenario, it's going to pick up about 30 megahertz this way and 30 megahertz down this way. So this may look like interference or not, but we're kind of looking for is kind of like a step down, right? If we have pretty much everything across about the same even plane, it means we have interference. So that's probably going to be the easiest way. Now, as you can see here, I'm pretty much on channel 36. I got some radios here. I also have some radios up in the upper bands as well. Because this uses 5 megahertz slices, it's actually going to pick up a little bit more. Now, the advanced is a little bit different. Right, let's go and click on advanced. And when you click the tab, you're going to basically see this. I already ran a scan here. You have a scan bandwidth, and then you'd be able to do either 5, 10, 20, and then you could do 40 megahertz either plus or minus. So it will be able to kind of pick up a little bit more. And after you've done that, just go click OK. Now, you click Start, and of course, it's going to kind of pick this up. So right now, we are actually using 20 megahertz. That's with a channel bandwidth that I'm currently using. So this is exactly what I want to see. So it's going to go ahead and pick up pretty much what it sees. And you can see it's a little bit different than the normal. Here you can kind of just see what's out there, but not all of these actually being occupied. It just kind of says that there's something over here, but because it could be in the side band of the channel, you may not know if it is or is not. Once again, if here it's pretty much in the same plane, the RSSI is all the same, chances are you're going to have an interferer. On the advanced side, it's a little bit different. Okay, so let's go ahead and take a look at the advanced spectrum analyzer screen. Fairly simple. We have our index here to the left. It's just number, count, how many devices are picked up, bandwidth. This is our channel bandwidth. Because we are using 20 megahertz, that's what it's picking up. If we were using 5 megahertz, it will pick up 5 megahertz. Here's the channel. Okay, it's going to kind of break it down and see what channel it is. This is, again, fairly different than the basic, as the basic is scanning at 5 megahertz slices. So it might be picking up this channel, but it's also picking up the sidebands that go along with the channel. If we would select 5 megahertz, we'd most definitely probably see a little bit more. We have the MAC address. Because it is Wi-Fi based, you're still going to see a beacon, okay? That's being broadcast, and within the beacon, you're just going to see a MAC address, right? If it's a system name, now the system name itself is whatever you call the device. I mean, that's basically what it is. So a lot of times it's blank, or if it's just going to be system name or whatever you want to call it. So that's all it is. Now the modes. Now the modes are a little bit different. There are, let's see here, 5 modes. We have base station, which of course is going to be a BSU, okay, or an endpoint. You're going to have an SU, and that's the subscriber unit. You have an access point like we have here. Of course, that's an access point, average every day, AP. You will have a station. Now, the station is basically a Wi-Fi client coming from your laptop, your cell phone, because those actually do broadcast as well. So that's going to come up as a station. And last, there's going to be one as other. Now, the other is really going to pick up things like IBSS, or an independent basic service set, or better known as ad hoc, where you have two devices that are talking to each other. No access point is required, just like two laptops talking to each other. It's also going to pick up non-prox and warp devices, so you can have other manufacturers that are using the OFDM protocol, and if it's not picking it up as WARP, it's going to pick it up as other. So it's going to tell you there's other point-to-point, point-to-multipoint devices out there. Okay. We're going to have encryption. It's just telling you if it's using encryption. Here's our max SNR, max signal-to-noise ratio. Okay. And then over here to our right, we have the packing count. Now, this displays the packet count for the detected device. It is only looking at 802.11 frames, so it's not going to look at anything else other than 802.11 frames. So how much traffic is being transmitted at that particular time? That is basic. Once again, it's fairly simple. As always, if you have any questions, please contact Proxim Technical Support and be more than happy to assist you.
To learn more about Proxim Wireless and our solutions, please visit us at proxim.com or follow us at Twitter @Proxim.